Hello everyone, welcome to another episode of Financial Tidbits here with me, Royston at NOF. Today's topic is more localized. We'll be talking about the top Singapore blue chip stocks which the street is most upbeat about and the key theses behind their positive view. We'll be focusing on three Singapore companies in this list that has garnered the greatest number of positive calls from the street, and based on consensus target prices, these stocks have an upside potential of between 21% to 38% from their current share price level. I'm generally also positive on these stocks, given a longer horizon. Again, this is not a recommendation to buy or sell these stocks, but to bring to your attention blue chip companies that might be undervalued, according to the street. Do, however, take these recommendations with a pinch of salt and do your own due diligence.
The company Aerotime International. It is a cutting-edge high-tech firm out of the Midwest awaiting imminent patent approval on a next generation of radar detectors that have both huge military and civilian applications. Now, right now, John, the stock trades over the counter at 10 cents a share. And by the way, John, our analyst indicator could go a heck of a lot higher than that. Your profit on a mere $6,000 investment would be upwards of $60,000.
With that, the first company that is on the top of analyst buy list is Wilmar. The street has an average target price of $6.35 on this counter, which represents an upside potential of almost 40%. Being an integrated player, Wilmar is a well-diversified company that benefits from higher commodity prices as well as downstream consumer product sales. For example, UOB believes that the company will benefit from high commodity prices of tropical oil and sugar. Likewise, OCBC holds a similar view. Consumption recovery, particularly in China, will set to drive demand for Wilmar's higher quality food products, according to Maybank. I have personally written about Wilmar on a number of occasions, particularly on the listing of its key subsidiary, Yihai Carry, or YKA for short, which now boasts a stunning market cap of approximately Chinese yuan 474 billion or close to Sing 100 billion. Wilmar owns 90% of YKA, which means that its stake in YKA is worth almost 90 billion alone, a staggering 3 times the market value of the entire Wilmar group, which has a market cap of just 30 billion. That is definitely mind-boggling. It's either YKA is super overvalued or Wilmar is super undervalued. The street seems to be favoring the latter, and Wilmar itself has been buying back shares in the market with the last transacted price at around $4.65. With a yield almost close to 3%, this counter should be a decent candidate to buy and hold and wait for the valuation gap between itself and YKA to shrink. The second Singapore blue chip company that the street is positive about is Ascendas REIT, with most brokerage houses having a buy rating on the firm and an average target price of $3.71, representing almost 30% upside from its current share price. Ascendas REIT used to be the largest REIT in Singapore before the merger of CapitaLand Mall Trust and CapitaLand Commercial Trust to form CapitaLand Integrated Commercial Trust. Ascendas REIT has been one of the most operationally resilient REITs heading into the COVID-19 pandemic, although not totally immune, as can be seen from a slight drop in its FY 2020 DPU from 15.6 cents to 14.7 cents, the first such decline in more than a decade. Nonetheless, being an industrial REIT, the company has properties that are generally very resilient despite COVID-19 impact on the global economy. The street believes that there are several tailwinds for A-REIT. For example, demand for certain sectors such as the high-tech space, e-commerce, and warehouse logistics will continue to bolster demand for A-REIT's assets. Also, office decentralization could result in greater demand for A-REIT's business park properties, which account for the bulk of its asset class. According to DBS, the company is also trading at a forward yield of 5.4%, which is one of the highest among the large cap industrial REITs such as Mapletree Industrial Trust and Mapletree Logistic Trust. Ascendas REIT is a company which I do also have a position in, and I like the fact that it is a resilient blue chip REIT with a decent forward yield of more than 5%, and for the fact that it is now trading near its 52-week low, which allows me to dollar cost average cheaper into this counter with a longer term horizon in mind. Like Warren Buffett, I do love seeing red on some of my long-term stock holdings. This means opportunity when blood is splattered all over the street. The last company that is highly favored by the market is yet another REIT, but unlike Ascendas, which is an industrial REIT, this company is a retail REIT and is none other than Frasers Centrepoint Trust, Singapore's leading suburban retail REIT, with its portfolio comprising 10 quality suburban retail malls. The proximity of suburban malls to homes and transport amenities makes their malls ideal last mile fulfillment hubs, especially with the trend of work from home. With more people working from home, there is an increasing trend where suburban malls are now extremely crowded during lunch hours. There are a number of key points which the street is bullish about on FCT. The fact that it is a suburban mall places it at an advantage versus other REITs with more downtown mall exposure. Another key point is that the company has been active on the asset recycling front, divesting away its smaller properties at above market valuation and using the capital to buy into larger properties with better yield potential. Lastly, with a forward yield of around 5.5%, FCT is definitely a REIT that is worth considering at its current price, one which I believe will be able to weather the COVID-19 storm in one piece. These are the top Singapore blue chip stocks that have garnered a high number of buy calls as well as trading at a substantial discount to their supposed fair value. I do think that all three are decent stocks if one has a long investment horizon, but the one that I'm keeping my eyes out on with a short-term trading angle is FCT, which could see a positive buy entry pretty soon based on the Traders GPS platform, a proprietary trading platform that identifies stocks to enter before it breaks out. Now, don't get me wrong, this is no crystal ball trading software, but one which has been time-tested to give traders that additional edge to spot potential breakout stocks. For those who are interested in finding out more about the Traders GPS platform, you can check out the link in the description below. That's it for today's financial tidbits. Once again, if you enjoyed the video, do hit the like button and subscribe to the NAOF YouTube channel. This is Royston, signing out.